Hello, welcome to the Wednesday, November 14th, 2018 edition of the Sands and its Storm Centers Stormcast. My name is Johannes Ulrich, and today I'm recording from Jacksonville, Florida. Microsoft's Patch Tuesday, of course, is at the top of the news today, and we got the patches for 63 different vulnerabilities, 12 of which are rated critical by Microsoft. Now, two of the vulnerabilities had already been publicly disclosed. The first one is the ALPC privilege escalation vulnerability that was released via Twitter by Sandbox Escaper, very similar to a vulnerability that the same individual released a few months prior, also via Twitter. Microsoft isn't aware of this vulnerability being used in any public exploits. The second one we have talked about recently, and that's the problem with BitLocker on Windows. And Microsoft published a patch for this as well as an advisory. There are two problems here. First one is that BitLocker does rely on hardware encryption in drives, and that sort of makes sense if you think about it. There is really no need to spend extra CPU power in encrypting data that would be encrypted on the hard drive anyway. So BitLocker ties in with these hard drive encryption technologies that have been popping up in various hard drives. But recently we learned that some of these hard drive encryption technologies aren't really all that good and can easily be bypassed. So the advisory that Microsoft released was that if you don't trust your hard drive, you can always just force BitLocker to encrypt the drive using its software encryption. Now, the second issue, and that's where the patch comes in, that's CVE-2018-8566, is an unspecified condition where BitLocker just stops encrypting a particular drive, and this is being addressed with this patch. So if you do want to play it safe, you can always just follow the Microsoft advisory and enable the software encryption in BitLocker, no matter whether or not your hard drive does support hardware encryption. Probably doesn't hurt from a security point of view, but you may get a little performance hit if you do enable this double encryption. There isn't really an easy way for you to test whether or not your hard drive encrypts the data correctly. In order to test it, you would have to typically swap out firmware on the hard drive, and that's nothing you really sort of want to do on a production machine, just to test whether or not the encryption works correctly. And then there's also a vulnerability that Microsoft addressed that actually has been exploited in the wild, but no details have been made public before today. And that's a Win32K privilege escalation vulnerability, CVE-2018-8589. Aside from that, again, lots of patches for Microsoft browsers. One interesting critical vulnerability in the TFTP server that comes as part of the Windows deployment services, and a remote code execution vulnerability in Microsoft Dynamics 365. This one affects the on-premise version of the product, so not if you're using it in the cloud. And then we got also updates from Adobe for Flash Player, for Adobe Acrobat and Reader, and for Photoshop Creative Cloud. Now, all of these vulnerabilities only lead to information disclosure, so no remote code execution here, but at least the one for Acrobat and Reader could potentially leak your NTLM hashes. This is a vulnerability that has existed in a number of products and also has existed before in PDFs. And the problem here is that PDFs can load external content. If this external content happens to be an SMB file share, then your Windows system will automatically send password hashes to this system. So while this is still correctly classified as information disclosure, it's probably the kind of information you don't necessarily want to release. And an exploit is actually pretty straightforward as long as you allow outbound SMB connections. Well, and this is it for today. So thanks for listening and talk to you again tomorrow. Bye.